Hello everyone, my name is Jerry Sean. I am the founder of Tintbolt. In this video, I am going to quickly show you how to track your finances in Tintbolt. So if you're on desktop, you go to the left-hand side here. We have our menu or our navigation. On mobile, you'll want to click the menu button or the navigation button and then click finances. So on our first screen here, we have the projected and actual revenues for the month. These numbers are calculated. So the projected number is calculated based on all the bookings currently in your schedule for the month. And the actual revenue is all the bookings whose revenue you added specifically. So when you go into any of your bookings and you open up a detailed view of your booking, you just click the little green button that says add revenue, and then it'll add these here. This little red icon is a credit card. If you offer or if you use a payment processor and you offer, for example, card payments as an option to your customers, you'll want to click this little button on, and it'll turn on processing fees for this transaction. I'm going to turn that off because I don't use that, but I'll show you where you manage and set those things up. So here we'll go into this options button if you're on desktop. If you're on mobile, it'll just be three vertical buttons. So click it. We'll go to expenses. And here is where you're going to just enter in the expenses that you have for your tint business. And I'll just go through this with you. In this case, I kind of wrote it down. So for this month of April so far for S3 Tint, I have $582.54 for film. So I'm just going to add that. And then I have $30.28 for shipping. Actually, just round that up to $30. And there we go. And then, so this payment processing piece here. So if you had a, so if you're, let's say you're with Square, and I think Square has a 3% fee per transaction, I believe. And then they have a flat rate as well. So you would add whatever that percentage is, and then that flat rate, and then you would save it. If you have a shop, you would put in your shop rent. In this case, I'll put nothing because I work out of my garage. If you have a phone for your business, or if you have a phone that you use like your personal phone and you use it for your business, enter in the amount here, then add it. And then for those of you who are watching this video, you might be using Tintbolt, and so you'd want to put in the amount that you're paying for Tintbolt. And then you can actually add in additional fixed or variable cost for your business, whatever that might be. Okay. So let's say, for example, you have a vehicle, or you rent some sort of machinery, maybe a jack or of some sort, whatever it is, you would add that here. And then we're going to move on to the next part, which is profit and loss. These numbers are calculated from the information that we just inputted right before, and then we'll get our percent of revenue, so like our profit, our gross profit, and our net profit. This is where you get that information, and in this case, based on the information that I just inputted with you guys, and based on my revenue, my profit margin is 82%, basically. Okay, and then the final part, you can go into the personal finance, and here's just a little feature just to help you guys manage your personal finances. If you don't have a budgeting system already in place, you can use Tintbolt for that. You would just add whatever the, here you can add an extra income, and then here you can add personal expenses. All right, so that's just a quick video on how to use the financing system in Tintbolt to just keep track of your revenue, your cost, and your P&L. All right, guys, if you have any questions, you can just reach out to me. You can find me on Facebook, or you can join our Facebook group on Facebook. Obviously, that would be Facebook. And you can also message me throughout my email. And if you guys are using Tintbolt, if you go into the top right-hand side, if you're on desktop, hit that user icon, you can get my contact information, my email. All right, so if you have any questions, just let me know. Take care. Bye.